Hello, hello, and good morning, guys and girls. And today, we're going to play, or you're going to watch me play, Atari's Batman arcade game. This masterpiece was developed in arcades in 1990. From 1991, it was released in Japan much later. This game is just as based as the storyline based upon Tim Burton's movie, Batman. And this game utilizes a lot of those things that is implemented towards the movie very well towards the game. Now, what's special about this is that they used a lot of well back then digitized photos for the movie. So you're going to see a lot of scenes prior from it, utilizing that from the movie. And yeah. So without further ado, let's be Bruce Wayne for a good minute in the game. And let us start the game.
Don't kill me, man!
I'm not going to kill you. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to tell all your friends about me.
What are you?
I'm Batman.
Okay. So, this is Batman. The game. And the game? Well, let's just say it's pretty good. It's a lot of interesting graphics towards this for it to be Atari. It gives off the the graphics gives off like a MS-DOS vibe for me, but nonetheless, for it to be an arcade game, you know, it's not bad. Maybe, you know, I don't want to be too judgy, but the game's not bad. Batman is literally kicking some major butt in this game. But what I've learned thus far in this game, the game is very fast, quick pace, so you don't have to fight almost every enemy like I was doing, because I end up dropping every time, kissing and hugging the floor with Batman countless of times. So I found out in this game, you want to just fight necessary foes, get through certain parts of the objective of the game, hit enemies that are in your path, and just keep it moving. You see the Batman icon? Grab that. That is also life energy. And life energy, when I played, I thought, oh, okay, I'm going to wait till all the energy is done. But no. One part energy stops the game, and you reset from what part wherever you were from. So now, we're at Axis Chemicals, just like in the movie. And not bad. But before we get to that, let's talk about Side Deliverance. This game is amazing. There's parts in the game where you have side bonuses where you can drive Batman's Batmobile and start shooting all the thugs out of the way to get to his objective, and I thought that was pretty cool. So, not bad for that to be additional towards the arcade game at the time back in the 1990s. So nonetheless, I was impressed. More to it. Now we're at Axis Chemical Plant and we're trying to find Jack Napier, aka the Joker. For people who didn't know, who are new to Batman. But for old school people, don't worry about it. You know who he is. So, with that being said, the area is, oh my god, did he just jump in the pit? He just sacrificed his soul. Y'all seen it? Dang. Whoa. He gone. He ain't gonna be a Batman 2. So anywho, yeah, this game was actually fun. You know, Batman has a lot of arsenal of various weapons, such as the Batarangs, gas grenades, and he can use his zipline gun sometimes too as a weapon, I guess. I barely use it in this game, so I wouldn't really know. But to start off, the game starts off very simple, you know, in the beginning. But then once you get to this chemical plant and get to other areas in the game does get a little bit harder and it does get a little bit tougher. So it's really, 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 really tough. This game has some tough mobility, which means movement. So it's really hard to move around, and he jumps a little stiff at times, which it's whatever. But the game does make up for it for certain extents in the game. You gotta watch out for toxic drips that can damage and hurt Batman. So you gotta watch out for that. And me, you see, I just got shot to the ground, and that ended Batman's career just that fast. So yeah, watch out for that. Unless you wanna get popped by these mean Gotham goons, cause they don't play games, cause they do massive damage with their guns. Watch them. Bloop! Put Batman to sleep! So yeah, you gotta watch out for that, man. Like, the goons hit really, really hard here. I believe they take a mad juice of points. But then I realized that's Jack Napier with his Magnum. I'm just like, oh, no wonder he hits hard. So yeah, we did him a favor and knocked him to the zest pull of toxin. You know, kept it pushing. So, after all, we're in the next area. Same area, the same art gallery that was in the movie. And I thought that was pretty cool that they implemented that as well. The area did get a little tough and ridiculous to a point. I was about to just lose my mind because, dude, it's all about mathematics, you know. Jump down the ledge, jump on top of the ledge, jump down the ledge, jump to the top of the ledge, you know when to jump in and out, you know what I mean? And you gotta watch out for enemies coming through the door. Some enemies have massive damage. You gotta be blessed to say, oh, maybe it's the melee goons, or oh, it's the gun goons. So if you're trying to busy to shoot, they can shoot their bullets across the area where you can't see, and you just get one shot, and it's all over. It's all over. It's all over. There's no coming back from that. So I'm just like, come on with your guns, man. Jeez. And then they dropping stupid gun bombs. I don't know, man. Gunpowder bombs is just, ugh. The game is fun, but the enemies can be a hot mess. They do so much damage, and they put so much in front of you to get towards your path in the game. So you have to watch out for so many of those objectives, man, just to get this stupid broad. Yeah, I said it. Just to save her from the Joker. But for you to get through this, you gotta worry about Joker's freaking jack-in-the-box Joker heads and shooting bombs from that. His minion goons are throwing bombs at you, shooting you with 45 magnums. And then you gotta worry about these stupid green balloons. Why do I even play this game? I'll tell you why. It's for your entertainment. And for you to see me flip a gasket. This is ridiculous. So, anywho, we die a couple of times from this dumb, godforsaken area. For the sake of YouTube, I played this game. Because I may not be Batman, but I'm Batman for a day. I'm Batman for a day. Alright, anywho, so we get past that part. And we got more goons, of course, just throwing stuff at us, and it was running at us with knives like a horror movie. I'm just like, man, I can't take no more of this. I'd rather play the newer Batman games, man. Don't get me wrong, I enjoy my classics, but this Batman game was ridiculous. This game is awfully short, but I see why this was a coin milker back then. The enemies were too dumb tough. They were on steroids. And don't even get me started with the Joker. His knife game was ridiculous. This dude should have been a juggler than a comedian, because this dude was juggling knives on me. Like, which way should I go? Should I go high, low, mini mo, eeny, miny, mo? I'm just like, man, would you? So I just started throwing the mess out of my gas bombs. And then he saw that. He took off. He said, no, I had enough. You better. The Batman said, get in the car. So now we have another bonus stage. Now we got to try to shoot all of the Joker's minions and their goons out of their green cars, blah, blah, blah. Which wasn't a bad bonus stage. You know, it's the same thing. You know, you're just in the car, you're trying to shoot cars to get out the way to get to their objective. So basically, the yellow bar you see up top, yep, right there. That yellow bar right there. Yeah, right there, right there. Right there, right there, right there, right there. Yeah, but anyway, seriously, right there, that yellow bar, that is your objective bar to get to the next stage. If it goes slow and you're not doing much, it'll shrink back down, I think, slightly. But if you keep the progression going and you're shooting all the cars, shooting all the missiles from all of the cars, then you'll be able to get to the next area. And we did so with ease. So now we're in this next area, and then we're now about to go inside this building to go get the Joker. Because you know, enough's enough. It's time for action. And this area wasn't too bad, but it was, psych, I was wrong. This part was dumb. I died so many times just because he wouldn't go up the ladder right. It was stupid, man. I was, dude, the way they set up objectives and different, things in this area, it's ridiculous. I would rather deal with Medusa Head several times in Castlevania, but to deal with this nonsense, only for certain reasons, all right? Reason one, these areas should be having stuff scattered like that super close. Not saying that as Savannah to be a challenge. Shouts out to people who are playing this on YouTube and they can do this with a run with no damage. You're God tier. You're not human. You're a robot. You're an AI program machine. Because there's no way in Davy Jones flip-flocking that you could be doing this like that. It is impossible. I'm sorry. I'm calling it out. Don't get me wrong. I am a game fanatic. I love games. I enjoy games. Games is my life. Games is my career. I want it to be my career. But nonetheless, this game was tough. Period. So anyway, we get past this roofing area through all this nonsense, right? And we get through all this nonsense, and we saw this guy with the double blades, similar to the guy that's in the movie where Batman had to give him the works. Y'all remember him? Yeah, the guy he was putting in work? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Familiar.
Nope.
Now, we're at the same part like it is in the movie. We're, you know, we're flying around trying to grab these balloons from the Joker, because we know in those balloons is loaded with all types of laughing gas. He wants to spread it all over Gotham to give it a laughing gas mayhem where people will laugh forever, and we don't need that. So with that being said, I found out how to do it. All I had to do was just put my character or focus Batman's plane or jet or bat jet right into the center to try to snag and grab all of these balloons, which successfully gets on the Joker's nerves, and he didn't like that too much. No, he didn't. Oh. I wouldn't say that in his face though, like I did. He would have blown me to smithereens or killed me slow for fun. But hey, that's the Joker. Don't mess with him. So that being said, we were able to grab all of his balloons. And he didn't take that too well. Not one bit. He was heated. But hey, I did what I had to do. Sorry, Joker. I had to grab these balloons, man. We can't have you having people laugh. And then he shoots me out of the air, blows up my bat jet plane. So now we're in the final area, just like in the movie, the Gotham City Cathedral, to find the Joker once and for all and stop his madness. This stage wasn't too bad, but it was really hard for lots of reasons. This place had many crevices that had open spots and open spaces. And I don't know what was wrong with my arcade stick today, but it was ridiculous. I could barely jump the way I wanted to. And me, I am very delicate with a lot of my electronical systems. Not like people online who rages and throw their joysticks like a boomerang out of heck. And then thinking that, I'm like, dude, you paid a lot of money for that. Like, why would you want to break your joystick? Like, what's the, I understand they do it for entertainment, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, followers today, watch this, yeah. I'm like, no, man, I want my joystick. I take care of my system, I take care of my electronics, and I'll be darned if I do that because for the sake of entertainment. Now, don't get me wrong, if it say, hey, for 15,000 followers, would you break all of your joysticks? No. Some people, you know, can't afford it, man. And I'm one of those guys. I can't afford joysticks like that. This is just not going to happen. You know, it's a lot of money. But anywho, back to this lovely game. So this game was giving me the beats, and they was beating the stuffing back cushion out of Batman, literally. Like I didn't stand a chance. And then the Joker wasn't no better. I'm trying to spam the mess out of these gas bombs. I'm like, catch all this, take it, do. And then he hit me. I'm just like, what? I'm like, all right, bro. And I said, what all did I fall in a hole? Come on. Jeez. This game, I'm sorry. This game getting on my nerves. Oh my God. So I just started button mashing, button arcade tapping that punch button, and then that was enough to make him run somewhere else. So I said, all right, I had about a lot of gas grenades. So I just started throwing them crazy. But now, you know, we're back to the Batmaring, and then we run out of that. So now we're back on our fisticuffs with Batman, and I'm trying my best not to fall in another hole. And then here we go again. Here come the Joker. I'm trying to throw stuff at him. He's hitting me, and he's doing his little pimp walk. I'm just like, I jumped in the hole again. Come on.
Oh my God.
Oh, man. Dude, this game is really, really taking me there, bro. I don't rage, but I definitely get annoyed. And the Joker was getting annoyed, so I kicked him down the hole. No, I didn't. I said, all right. Take two. I said, all right, let's get him again. I said, all right, let's go. Okay. I said, all right. I said, yep. Catch all them knees. You about to break dance today, party. Let's go. Catch all that in the knees. Catch all that in the knees. Jump kick. Yep. Go in that hole. Sick of you. Somewhere you need to be. In the dumps. Who's laughing now? So, yeah. Now we're at this one part where there's bells. And let me tell you, I didn't pay attention. Those bells were killing me back to back. And it was annoying. I hated these bells. These bells were the worst. They were the worst. They were the worst. The worst.
But you see now, you're the fucking idiot.
I couldn't stop dying. I had to continue like so many times. It's because they do so much damage. So I try to just try to run through it. But then you gotta worry about enemies. They'll kind of stop you, so you get hit, you get hurt. And then you gotta worry about the double dagger guy again. I'm like, man, I ain't got time for your mess. So I jumped over to the upper level, because I'm like, I'd rather deal with the guys up top than the purple jackets, because I'm like, I'm not doing this. So then we're at the final part, but then of course we die again. Anyway, we're at the final part, and this time, this is the last bout with me and the Joker. So I'm giving Joker the business the best way I can, or trying to at least, because he's giving me a hard time, and he's just like resistant to these Batmarangs. I'm just like, man, what's your stuff made out of? Batman plastic? Because I'm like, it's not doing nothing. Like, you better start hitting these kneecaps, start doing jump kicks. And that's exactly what I did. But for how long could it do? I was like, man, I'm like, oh my God, dude. Oh my God. Yeah, so this was really annoying out of all fights, but I couldn't take it no more. I said, you gotta go. I said, if we both gotta fall, we both gonna fall. Which kind of funny, because in the movie they kind of did both fall together, so that was interesting. Interesting. But the review. Yes, this game was fun. Very difficult, very challenging, very hard to play. This is a game I don't recommend seeing somebody play that many times. This is a one and done. You beat it, move on. It's in your brain collection of games you beat. With that being said, do I recommend this game for everyone? Yeah, why not? Sure. I give this game a crispy 9 out of 10. It was a really, really great game. I was surprised Atari made a game like this where, you know, it's inspired by the movie at that time, a month release of the movie back in 1989. And then a year later, they made the game. So, that was interesting. And just imagine how fast the time they had to do to make that. Not bad. So yeah, this game was great. It was fun. I'll be proud. Gotham City be proud. No, I don't think so. They'll probably break the whole arcade machine. But with that being said, that's the game review. That's the game. And that's it. In the video.
Batman thought he was bad. He was a fucking asshole in the first place. He got knocked to the floor. I whooped Batman's ass. I whooped Batman's ass. I whooped Batman's ass. I whooped Batman's ass.
And hey, we are at the end of the video. You made it this far, that means you are awesome. Don't forget to click that like button. And most importantly, don't forget to arcade tap that subscribe button. You all have a great day.